There are a few of us are attending the program physically while the rest are watching virtually to celebrate Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav, to commemorate 75 years of India's independence. The fruit we have in our hands in the shape of a fruit is the hard work of thousands of leaders, lakhs and lakhs of workers, their commitment and dedication. The air of freedom that is surrounding this place, the country, is the project, is the product of their effort. Before we come to the present, I am of the view that I must, on my behalf and on behalf of all of you, express my pranams and gratitude to all the great leaders and freedom fighters of the nation who fought for our independence and delivered to us a free India from the shackles of colonial rule. All of you know, today is the birth centenary of Mahatma Gandhi and also Lal Bahadur Shastri. One was a steel character in freedom movement, another is a stellar performer of character and conduct. I pay my homage and respects to all the noble souls who have sacrificed their lives during the struggle for freedom of India. The country we have, the independence we relish within the territory is also not possible without the sacrifices and the dedication our defense personnel are showing in protecting the territory and integrity of India. My respectful salutations to all the defense personnel of our country. Now, respected district judge Mr. P. Krishna Kumar and his companion judicial officers, Secretary, District Legal Services Authority, I may be excused for not taking all the names of the dignitaries who are present here, who are present there, and who have taken their precious time to participate virtually in this program, because my district judge has given to me 15 minutes to 20 minutes to bring home the good idea he says I must convey to you. In between referring to the names and sharing my idea with you, being a practical man, I prefer to share my idea than referring all the names here, there, everywhere. Do appreciate and do not mistake me. My special appreciation and wishes to the law students and particularly the energetic law students I see here. And when I prepared for my speech, I didn't know the commitment I can see in your eyes, in your body language. Otherwise, I would have added two more sentences in my speech to say that the Constitution and my country would be safe in the hands of this generation. Dear all, I extend my appreciation to all of you once again and invite you not only to this program but also to the task I would be requesting you to voluntarily perform in the coming days to come. The National Legal Services Authority and KELSA have given detailed guidelines for participation and performance of all the objectives enunciated by our country on this momentous occasion. The stakeholders are judicial officers, legal aid functionaries, panel lawyers, presidents, secretaries of the bar associations of Thiruvananthapuram district. Now I have the advantage of the president of bar association Thiruvananthapuram. I have the advantage of law students to share my idea, and a few of the representatives of law colleges. My list would be incomplete if I do not refer to the foot workers who really matter a lot in Legal Services Authority. They are paralegal volunteers, social workers, NSS volunteers of the colleges and representatives of NGOs. All the stakeholders, we are witnesses to a momentous history in our country. I may slightly digress from my written script. When the learned district judge invited me to deliver the inaugural address, standing in front of students, I should also be candid so that they will also learn the rectitude, whether it is on stage or off stage. I was in two minds. Why? So many restrictions are there, COVID, etc. Why go? Instead, discharge my duty as a judge and dharma as a constitutional judge by virtually participating in this program. I have no doubt in my mind that had I gone with my first option, I would have certainly missed it in my life to see the enthusiasm with which the present generation is celebrating the Platinum Jubilee of our independent India. I am really happy for having come here. The present outreach program of NALSA and KELSA commences today, and the finale of this program is scheduled on 14th November 2021. This program encompasses dissemination of knowledge on fundamental duties under the Constitution of India, help to victims of crimes, early access to justice, laws relating to senior citizens, child rights under POCSO Act, etc. I prefer to restrict my inaugural speech with reference to fundamental duties of citizens and the participative role we can reinvent, cultivate, and continue to practice for the growth and in the growth of our vibrant India. I am saying for and in. I am conscious when I am using both the expressions. While delivering inaugural address, I am obliged to ensure the tempo of the program for the next 1 month. As we commence the Platinum Jubilee celebrations, we could also plan to complete the Centenary Jubilee celebration with creation of more wealth, more welfare and well-being to our present and future generations and citizens of our country. Just now, I am also one among you while I have listened to the exhortation of His Excellency the President of India that we have to celebrate our 100 years by accomplishing more goals, by accomplishing more objectives as a democratic and republic India. This we can legitimately dream today. It would remain a dream if we do not get down and perform. Every day, everyone gets a dream. Only one who remembers the dream he has got in the wee hours of the day starts completing the job he has undertaken, they are alone the successful candidates and they are alone the leaders. My effort now is to delegate a few responsibilities to the younger generation to think, emulate and follow a few of the ideals under the Constitution. Platinum Jubilee celebration is a momentous occasion for everyone in independent India. I am honored and blessed to be the guest delivering inaugural address on the occasion of inaugural function at Thiruvananthapuram. I am also honored and blessed to be in the midst of noble, enthusiastic and ever alacrity students to give my inaugural speech. I, on behalf of the Khalsa and District Legal Services Authority, request the heads of educational institutions to actively participate in disseminating the programs of the National Legal Services Authority, and I am laying emphasis, voluntarily pledge your support and practice the ideals, fundamental duties enshrined in Article 51A, particularly on this occasion with reference to clauses B, G and H as part of your life throughout. I have requested my district judge to make the pledge we are proposing to hand over advance copy to the young generation, because they are liars in the making. Unless they read fully, unless they understand fully, they will not commit themselves. Am I right or wrong? Students are not answering. Unless you read, unless you understand, you will not commit to a situation. This pledge is already given to all of you. This is a voluntary pledge. We as elders, officers and responsible citizens, we are exhorting you to look at it and think about it, and if it appeals to you, on its turn in this speech, you can be one among other people who would be pledging their support and implementation of the oath now we are placing before you. There is one more advantageously disadvantageous situation in Kerala. My officers may be wondering, he is a judge coming from Andhra Pradesh, why he is speaking about disadvantage? There is. Kerala has the reputation of having highest literacy in the country. Being a state with highest literacy, expectation from you to be more literate is proportionately high. Slightest deviation, slightest ignorance is also not appreciated by anyone within the society, and also a guest who is staying in the state of Kerala will also see what is this exception in Kerala. Everyone follows rule, why this man is not following? Keeping that advantage in mind, you have a greater duty to contribute for the working of our fundamental duties. The law students present here may be wondering, as students and future professionals, what is the role we have in wealth, welfare, and creation of wealth in the society? These are all the matters normally looked after by engineers, IT professionals. You call any engineer, doctor, so on and so forth, we are only concerned to three letters, LAW, law. What is the role it has to play in the development of a nation? There, I slightly disagree with you. Development is always associated with establishment of factories, construction of dams, irrigation channels, expanding the area of agriculture, health, information technology, artificial intelligence, everything. Establishment, if it is treated as one facet of it, the continuation of these facilities, they are always dependent on the values the Constitution of India has ingrained in itself and the rule of law in the country. Who would ultimately be dealing with values of constitutional law and rule of law would be law students and lawyers. Therefore, even as law students and professionals in the making, you can have your vision beyond the horizon. Beyond the horizon, you can have your vision, modulate and adapt to accomplish more goals in your life. Dear all, I have, and I am sure, to the extent available at my disposal and command, tried to inspire you to appreciate the effort the District Legal Services Authority, Thiruvananthapuram, is making. There is one trouble in human nature. To convince you more, I may refer to a few judgments, because you are all taking a call which completely runs on precedent. This decision has done it, held like this, precedent like this, so on and so forth. And this will become an academic session where you may think that the person who rendered the inaugural speech has partly discharged the job of our professors. They feel what we ought to have done, the judge has done. By doing so, I will be having dissatisfaction from both the quarters. Therefore, I am not either doing that. The simple thing I can tell you is, we are now celebrating Platinum Jubilee of Independent India. Did it ever come to you that the centenary celebration will come in 2047? Anyone who has got this idea can raise his or her hand. Only students. You got it? When our nation celebrated its 50th year of independence, I was also as blissfully ignorant and oblivious as all of you are. As a professional, I was minding my work, going to court, coming back. Oh, I just said 1947, 50 years over. It never came to me that when it comes to Platinum Jubilee celebration, I will be invited as a guest to deliver inaugural address at District Legal Services Authority, Thiruvananthapuram. Now, the tag to the story is not over. I don't know. When it comes to 2047, one or a few of you may be this side. Being patriotic, I may be there. When you stand here, what I am telling you today should not come to your mind, that the judge has told us that given the time, keep doing something for the nation, keep doing something for the country, keep doing something for the fundamental right, fundamental duties enshrined in the Constitution. I do not want you to have this regret feeling when you will be taking lead part in our centenary celebrations in 2047. Now, we are all reaping the fruits of the efforts of our forefathers, freedom fighters, and brave soldiers who have sacrificed to unshackle the nation from the clutches of colonial rule. When you are all born, at least I can say, the system is in a position to provide either a steel spoon or silver spoon. When I was young, I could see only a plastic spoon. I can imagine when my father was born, there was not even a spoon, because they were all suffering under the yoke of colonialism. When you are enjoying the fruits of freedom, our exhortation to this generation is, please do pay back to the country when you are sharing the fruits of freedom, liberty of expression, liberty to have your own avocation, so many things which our Constitution has guaranteed to us. We all admire and believe that the course of our national leaders during independence movement is very relevant today, for no day passes without a human being encountering one problem or the other. We face, and at least I feel, we are duty bound to follow the wisdom of our leaders to build a great nation. This is important, where we respect human dignity, values, and liberty, do everything at our disposal and command to provide basic needs to all of our citizens in the country. Dear all, remember the fundamental duties enshrined in Article 51A. Do not coerce either me, he, or you to follow the duties. Enough literature is available on this to say this way or that way. But what is important is the most that can be said in a very general way is that a complacent Indian, a fully satisfied Indian will say that I follow fundamental duties if others are also following the fundamental duties. If this is the view that is entertained by all 130 crore citizens of our country, then are we doing anything which we can reasonably do in discharging the fundamental duties enshrined in our constitution? One of you can say yes or no. I see the stoic faces. It is no. Am I right or wrong? Don't think I am coercing an answer from you. I know the last thing a judge does is taking a coercion from a counsel. This side we don't do that at all. We will listen to you more and more, but reserve for ourselves what we have to do. This is very, very important in our approach. Look at it from that angle. Now you can tell yourself whether you want to be the front runner and lead others in the country, or in spite of all the advantages you have today, or you want anyone to lead you. Choice is yours. To be or not to be in a free and democratic country like ours, the choice is with you. If you inspire yourself, you can certainly accomplish miracles than what you are thinking today.